In this video, we're going to complete the KutaSoftware Infinite PreAlgebra free worksheet, Solving Systems of Equations by Graphing. Our directions on this worksheet are to solve each system by graphing, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Let's dive in to number one. Now, in order to solve a system by graphing, what we're going to do is we're going to graph each of the equations and then find that intersection point. That intersection point is our solution to the system. And what that means is if we took that point and plugged it into either equation, both will be true. So let's do this in number one. Starting with our first equation, we see that 1/3 x minus 4 has a slope of 1/3, and let's start by graphing that y-intercept because we only need 2 points for this line. So if we were to plug in 0 for x, that means that we would be at the point 0, negative 4. So negative 4 in the y. So 0, negative 4. There is the first point on our first line. Now with a slope of 1/3, remember slope is rise over the run. So if we go up 1, we go over to the right 3, since both are positive. So to graph our next point, we're going to go up 1 and then 3 to the right. So 1 up and 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3, to this point here, which I'll mark. Now, we've put 2 points for our first equation, so I can go ahead and draw this line. Now, I'm on my computer and don't have a straight edge handy, but feel free, if you printed this worksheet out, to get a ruler or some other edge to draw those nice straight lines on. Now we're going to move on to our second equation. In our second equation, if we were to plug in 0 for x, that's going to give us our y-intercept. And remember, our y-intercept is where we intersect this y-axis, which occurs at that positive 4. So we're going to plot the point 0, 4. Now we're going to use this slope and build off of that y-intercept. This says negative 7/3 is the slope. Remember, rise over run. So if we apply this negative to our numerator, we're going to go down 7, and then this is a positive 3, so 3 to the right. So down 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3. Oh look, we're at this point here. So lucky enough for us, this is going to be the intersection, so let's draw this line. And see here, this is indeed where those 2 points intersect. Now we just have to write what that value is. It's at 3 in the x and negative 3 in the y. So 3 comma negative 3 is our solution for this system of equations. And to show you why that is, let's quickly, for this problem, plug in our x value of 3. If I was to plug in 3 for x, both the 3s would cancel out in the denominator of each equation. So I have 1 minus 4, which equals a negative 3. There's that y value. And in my other equation too, I have negative 7 plus 4, which is also a negative 3, that same y value. So you can see that intersection point does indeed solve the system of equations. And we solved it by graphing. Let's move on to number two. In number two, we have y equals 1/3 x plus 3. So graphing this first equation, let's start by putting that y-intercept. Since we're in slope-intercept form, we can easily plug in a 0 for x and see that we're going to be at a positive 3 in the y. So 0, 3, and then now we're going to use the slope to find our next point. Rise over run, that's going to be 1 up and 3 to the right. So going 1 up and 3 to the right, we're going to be at this point here. So now let's go ahead and draw this line. Now moving on to our next equation, let's find that y-intercept first. So if we plugged in 0 for x, that term would go away and we're left with a negative 2. So we're at 0, negative 2. And then using our slope, which our slope is 2, we can also think of this as 2 over 1, rise over run. So when we go 2 up, we'll go 1 to the right, to this point here. Now I'm going to connect these by drawing my line. And this is where having that straight edge comes into play, because you will be able to find the intersection point very nicely, which occurs here. So that's 3 in the x and 4 in the y, So this is 3, 4 as our solution. Again, if we were to plug 3, 4 in for our x and y values, this equation will hold true. Plugging in 3 does indeed give us 4 for y, and that's for both equations. Let's move on to our next problem, number 3. For number 3, our first equation, again, is in slope-intercept form, which I believe they all are on this worksheet, which is convenient for us for graphing. So if I was to plug in a 0 for x, this first term goes away to leave me with a negative 3. So 0 for x results in negative 3 for y. So I'm going to graph the point 0, negative 3. Also, if you need help with this slope-intercept form and graphing equations, I'll leave a link down below or a card over here in the upper right side that'll take you to a video where I go more in depth and a little bit slower with how to actually graph these linear equations. But for now, I'm assuming that we already have a good understanding of how to graph and we're just finding that intersection point. So, now that that's said, continuing on, we're going to use our slope of negative 7 to find our new point along this line, basing it off of our y-intercept. Now think about this slope of negative 7, rise over run. If I put this over a positive 1, going down 7 is going to get me off of my charts. So, as opposed to applying the negative in the numerator, I'm going to make the numerator positive and the denominator negative. So I'm going to go up 7 and 1 to the left, 1 in that negative x direction. Now I'm going to connect these points with my line. And again, I recommend using a straight edge to make sure that line is nice and crisp. But for now, continuing on, our next line is y equals 4. Well, there's no x value in this equation whatsoever, which means that regardless of what x is, we always have y equal to 4. So x could be 0 and y is 4, x could be 1, y is 4, x could be negative 4, y is 4, and so on. This is just a horizontal line. And we can find that intersection point right here at negative 1, positive 4. So negative 1 in the x and 4 in the y, which we knew at the start we were going to have 4 in the y because we have to in order to have the second equation be true. There's no other possible y values. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, we have negative 2/3 x minus 2 equals y. Plugging in 0 for x, since we're in slope-intercept form, will give us our y-intercept of negative 2. So 0, negative 2. Then using our slope of negative 2/3, we can either go down 2 and 3 to the right, or up 2 and 3 to the left. I'm going to go down 2 and 3 to the right, to this point here. Again, we could have also went up 2 and 3 to the left. Either way of going about this is perfectly fine, because when you draw this line, we're going to get the same exact result. And there we have it. That's our first linear equation. Now let's move on to our second. When we plug in 0, we get a positive 4, so 0, 4 for that first point. And then using our slope, I'm going to go down 8 and 3 to the right, because if I tried to go up 8 and 3 to the left, I would be off of our charts. So going down 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3. Oh look, I hit the same exact point that I've already plotted. But let's go ahead and connect this line so that we can see it is indeed an intersection. And there we have it. You can see that we intersect at the point 3, negative 4. 3 in the x, negative 4 in the y. That's our solution for this system of equations in number 4. Now we're going to move on to the second page. However, before moving on, if you've been finding this video helpful, please let me know by clicking that thumbs up or like button down below. For now, let's continue on. We have y equals negative 2/3 x minus 3, and y equals negative 2/3 x plus 4. Notice for this, we have the same exact slope. So let's see what's going to happen. If we plug in 0 for x, we're going to be at negative 3 in the y. So 0, negative 3, and then we're going to use our slope of negative 2/3. So I'm going to go down 2 and 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3, to this point here. Now I'm going to connect these, forming my line. Now let's graph our second line. If I was to plug in 0 for x, I'm going to get a positive 4, and then again, same slope. So I'm going to go down 2 and 3 to the right, to this point here, and then connect those points. And what can you see about these two lines? There's no intersection between them. Because they have the same slope, they're going to continue on in that same direction, keeping the same distance between them the entire time, and they will never intersect. So in this case of number 5, there is actually no solution. There is no x value that we can plug into both equations and get the same exact y value. It's just not possible, so there's no solution. And again, this was because those lines had the same slope and different intercepts, so they were just parallel lines. Let's move on to number 6. In number 6, we have negative 6x minus 3 as our first equation, and then negative x plus 2 as our second equation, forming our system of equations. So we're first going to start by looking at, let's just mix things up and look at our second equation at the start. Plugging 0 in for x, we're going to get a positive 2 for y. So plotting that point, and then our slope you can see is negative 1 because we have a negative x. So negative 1 for my slope, I can either go down 1 and 1 to the right or up 1 and 1 to the left. Either way, those points will fall on that line. And there we have it. Now that I've graphed my second equation, let's go back to our first equation. Negative 6x minus 3, if I put a 0 in for x, this term goes to 0, so I get 0 minus 3, which is just a negative 3. So 0, negative 3. Now my slope is negative 6, so that's negative 6 over 1, or 6 over negative 1. I'm going to use 6 over negative 1 so that I can go up 6 and 1 to the left, to this point here, which is already on our other line, so we already know where our intersection is going to lie. But let me go ahead and connect those with a line. And you can see here is our intersection point at negative 1, 3. Therefore, if I was to plug in negative 1, 3, both of these equations would hold true. Let's think about it real quick. Plugging in negative 1 for x over here, I get a positive 6 minus 3, which does indeed give me that positive 3. And plugging negative 1 over here, I'll get a positive 1 plus 2, which again gives me 3. Let's move on to number 7. For number 7, we have y equals negative 3/4 x plus 4, and y equals 1/2 x minus 1. That's our system of equations, and we're going to find that solution by graphing. Starting with our first equation, if we were to plug x in as 0, we would get a positive 4 for y, so we're going to graph the point 0, positive 4. Then we're going to use our slope to find another point so that we can form that line. So negative 3/4, we're going to go down 3 and over 4 to this point here. Now let's go ahead and connect those points together. Now for our next equation, plugging in 0, we get a negative 1, so the point 0, negative 1. And then our slope is 1 over 2, so 1 up and 2 to the right to this point here. Now I'll connect those two points to form my next line. And there's my intersection point, right here at the point 4, 1, where those two lines cross. That is the system's solution, 4, 1. Now it's time for the last problem on this worksheet, number 8. If you've been finding this video helpful so far, don't forget to click that like button. Continuing on, however, we're going to start by plugging in 0 for x in our first equation. Since it is indeed in slope-intercept form, when we plug in 0, we're going to get that y-intercept, where that line intersects that y-axis, which is at the point 0, negative 4. So I'll go ahead and graph that now. Then I'll use my slope of rise over run, 5 over 2, to get another point along my line. So going 5 up and 2 to the right, to this point here. Now, I'll connect those points to form my line, because all I need is two points for a line. Now for my next equation. Again, it's in slope-intercept form. So if I plug 0 in for x, I'm going to get a positive 3 for y. That's where my line is going to cross the y-axis. And then using my slope of negative 1, going down 1 and 1 to the right, or up 1 and 1 to the left, either way is fine, but I'll go ahead and connect those points. And from there, you will be able to find that intersection at the point 2, 1. 2 in the x, 1 in the y. That is my solution for this last system. So with that, we wrap up this free KutaSoftware website worksheet. If you have any questions, again, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I or one of your peers will get back to you as soon as we can. But as always, to show your support, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!